Okay, yeah, assalamu alaikum everyone. Let's just start, and when Brother Amin joins, inshallah, he'll join. Regarding last few weeks' lessons, starting from Izhar, Iqlab, Ikhfa, Idgham, any questions? And how is everyone finding those rules while you're practicing, reading Quran? Or, yeah, how is everyone finding it?
No, alhamdulillah. I think the ikhfa letters, though, it's just
It's a lot.
trying to get that balance right in terms of the light nasal sound.
Yeah. Okay.
That's the only thing that.
Ikhfa normally takes a lot of time, okay? Because it's got the most letters and it is a bit hard. But just remember one thing, it's in between, it's like it's in between idgham. So we don't fully it's in between idgham and izhar, the way I explained it yesterday. What do we do in izhar? We read it clear and fast. But in here we don't read clear. We do gunnah. Okay? And in idgham, we ignore the letter totally. But we don't ignore the noon here. We hide the noon and we do gunnah. Okay, so instead of saying antum, we say antum, antum. We take the sound to the nose instead of pronouncing it from our tongue and saying antum with the makhraj. We straight take the sound to the nose. So instead of saying antum, we say antum, not amtum, antum like that. Slowly, slowly, it's going to come, inshallah. Has everyone been watching the YouTube video I sent here and there? Okay, if you watch that YouTube videos, if you watch that YouTube video, you will get a better understanding because he reads with very good makhraj. Okay, you can see, you can listen to exactly how he's pronouncing each letters, how he's doing idgham, how he's doing ikhfa, ikhlab. Okay, ikhlab and idgham is not really. You can see when I read ikhlab, I change it to a meme. You can see my lips are joining. It's the meme, makhraj of meme. When I do idgham, you can see, but ikhfa is you can't see because it goes to the nose. I know what you're trying to say, but inshallah, what? Let's do something. Let's wait for Brother Amin. He said he's 5 to 10 minutes late. Instead of starting the new subject, let me listen to everyone's Quran. In that way, he doesn't miss anything out. And then as soon as he comes, we'll stop Quran. We'll start the lesson, and then the remaining people who hasn't said the Quran, I'll listen to the end of the lesson. Is that okay? Because we've only got two more rules to do, and I really want. Okay, we've done the Nun Sakin and Tanwin rules. We've got Mim Sakin, and the Mim Sakin rules are very easy. If you understand all the rules in Nun Sakin, Mim Sakin is very easy. I don't really want him to miss it. So what I will do is, who volunteers to read Surah Fatiha and Surah Nas first?
Yeah, I can do.
Okay, Brother Imran's gonna do Surah Fatiha and Surah Nas first. While Brother Kibria and Brother Fahim, you practice. Yeah, if you want to listen to him, you can listen to him or you can practice. Yeah, Bismillah.
Shall I start, yeah?
Yeah, Bismillah.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. آمين.
MashaAllah. Okay, this ayin, your reading was very good, mashaAllah. But just this ayin, alayhim, and it sounded like you said ana amta. Just start from here, please. Siratul ladina again.
Okay. Siratul ladina an'amta alayhim. غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. آمين.
ما شاء الله. Very good. سورة ناس. قل أعوذ برب الناس.
سورة ناس. Okay. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. قل أعوذ برب الناس. Malikin,
I want you to say this again. I want you to say this again. I remember I told you last week.
Yeah.
There's a strong and there's a soft.
Okay.
أعوذ.
قل أعوذ بالله. نو وما سين. قل أعوذ برب الناس، ملك الناس، إله الناس، من شر الوسواس الخناس، الذي يوسوس في صدور الناس، من الجنة والناس.
Hey, mashallah, very good reading, Brother Imran. Okay, I'm just going to point two things out. Okay, A'udhu, you tried your best, mashallah.
Yeah,
I can see there's a lot of improvement. Okay, but we still need to work on it. Okay, you can work on it on this surah, or when we do surah Falaq, same thing. A'udhu bi Rabbil Falaq. Remember, A is strong, Ayn is soft. A'udhu,
yeah.
A'udhu. And there's another thing here. You made this ra full mouth. It's empty mouth. Sharri. Min sharri al-waswa. I told you because the ra has a shadda and it's got a kasra underneath. This ra is going to be empty mouth, okay? Min sharri, empty mouth. Is that okay?
Yeah, that's fine.
Okay, fix these two mistakes and inshallah... I'll listen to the remaining two brothers and we'll go to the next surah. Okay. Okay. Who wants to say next, brother? But overall, Brother Imran, very good reading. MashaAllah. Brother Fahim or Brother Kibri?
Yeah, I can pray.
Okay, Bismillah, go on.
A'udhu billahi minash shaitanir rajim. Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. Ar-Rahmanir Rahim. مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين
آمين ما شاء الله next one
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم
Surah Nas.
أعوذ برب الناس ملك الناس إله الناس من شر الوسواس الخناس الذي يوسوس في صدور الناس من الجنة والناس.
Okay, من الجنة. You done all the other. Yeah, all the other nun shadda you done more. Min al jinnati, you need to do it. Okay, mashallah, very good reading. Okay, the next person we will listen to, the only person left is Brother Kibriya. Bismillahirrahmanirrahim.
A'udhu billahi minash shaitanir rajim. Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen. Ar-Rahmanirrahim. Malik yawmiddin. Iyaka na'am. وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين
آمين ما شاء الله okay اهدنا الصراط you need to make this a bit more full mouth otherwise it becomes this letter If you don't say ihdina sira, if you don't say ihdina sira with a full mouth, it becomes ihdina sira. You did try to make it full mouth. It wasn't a full scene, but it was. You didn't make it into a full scene. You didn't even make it into a full sword. So it was somewhere in between. So if you just push it a bit more towards full mouth, it will become the right letter sira. Ihdina sirat al mustaqim. You just make your mouth a bit circle, a full mouth. Sirat al ladina. An'amta alayhim. The first hamza is strong. Ayn is soft. Ayn is soft. An'amta alayhim. An'amta alayhim. Just work on this, yeah?
An'amta.
Then?
Yeah. An'amta alayhim.
Perfect. MashaAllah. An'amta alayhim. That's good. MashaAllah. Very good. So just work on these... Alif, Ayn, Ayn. You can mark in your Quran, Sa'd and Sa'd. Just mark in your Quran. So every time you read, you're going to, when you come to this part, you're just going to be a bit extra careful or you're going to think before you read. Okay? These three. Okay, mashallah. And then we go to the next surah. Surah Al-A'udhu Rabbi Nas.
Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. قل أعوذ برب الناس، ملك الناس، إله الناس، من شر الوسواس الخناس، الذي يوسوس في صدور الناس، من الجنة والناس.
Can you start from here, please, again?
من شر من شر الوسواس الخناس، الذي يوسوس في صدور الناس، من الجنة والناس.
Okay. It's min shar. You have to do ikhfa. Can you remember we done ikhfa last lesson? After nun, sakin, wa tanwin, if few letters come, the remaining 15 letters, sheen is one of those 15 letters. Okay, so if after nun, sakin, wa tanwin, if sheen comes, we have to do ikhfa. We don't say min shari. If we say min shari, it becomes izhar. We are reading it clear and fast. We have to say min sharril. Yeah. Mio, take the sound to your nose. Mio,
not min.
If you say min, you're not hiding it. We have to hide the noon. We have to hide the sound of noon, and we have to do gunna. So instead of saying min sharri, we say mio sharri like that.
Mio
sharri. You don't have to make your mouth circle, and if you make your mouth circle, it becomes mio. Mim wow. Okay. Mio. No,
yeah, that's what it sounds like. Meal.
Yeah, it sounds like meal, but you take the instead of making that sound with your mouth, you take the sound to your nose. Meal sharri, meal sharri. If I was able to show it, I would have. I can't show how the sound goes to my nose.
Okay,
but instead of just look at my lips. Instead of saying meal sharri, look, my lips doesn't move. Meal sharri, meal sharri. I'm not saying meal sharri. I'm not making my mouth round and making it wow. I'm saying,
okay, so if I stop my lips from moving,
Listen, it's gonna be hard. It's gonna be hard. We practice, and one day it'll become perfect. Yeah, just keep on practicing. Just because it's hard, we don't give up. Once we give up, we lost. Yeah,
okay.
You practice, and our one, I practiced for years. Okay, at the beginning, I didn't know, I was finding it so hard, I didn't know how to say. But once you practice, and we have to listen to that Imam's Quran, okay? We see every time he does ikhfa, how he does it. And suddenly, inshallah, it will come. Min sharri. And then we have waswa. It sounded a bit, I don't know exactly what he like said.
Full mouth.
No, you didn't say, I think you said wasiwa. I think you put a kasra on sin. I couldn't really, can you just say this again, please? Min sharri.
So, mil sharri waswa.
Yeah, go on.
Waswasil khannas.
Okay, waswa. That's good. Mil sharri waswasil khannas. I thought you said wasiwa. Okay. Anyway, start from here again.
I read.
Yeah.
Too fast. That's.
Yeah.
It just.
Yeah. Maybe two letters. They just touched each other, and then it sounded like a haraka. Okay. Just start from mil sharri again.
Mil sharri waswasil khannas.
Min sharril. The lam has a sakin. Min sharril.
Min sharril waswasil khannas.
Khannas. Kha is full mouth. Not khannas. Kha.
Khannas.
Yeah. Alladhi.
Min sharril waswasil khannas.
MashaAllah.
Alladhi yuwaswisu fi sudurin nas.
That's very good. MashaAllah. Yeah. Min al-jinnati wa nas.
Min al-jinnati wa nas.
Yeah, just remember, when it's a sakin, it's a sakin, okay? We don't bounce our voice in a sakin. We don't say minala jinnati. If we say minala, it becomes like a qalqala, and lam doesn't have qalqala. Yeah? Okay, minala. But mashallah, very good. Mashallah, very good. But just a bit more practice needed, okay?
Okay.
Inshallah. Don't be sad or anything, but once we practice, it will become perfect. And we are here to learn. Okay, we are here to learn.
Exactly.
And inshallah, Assalamu alaikum, brother Amin. We were waiting for you, and alhamdulillah, you've joined us.
Sorry, I'm late.
No, it's okay. It's okay. What we done is we just took the lesson at the end, so you don't miss out on anything. And I'm just listening to everyone's Quran now, instead of doing Quran at the end. Okay, now it's your turn. Bismillah.
Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Sorry.
I'm going to listen to Surah Fatiha first. And if there is any mistakes, like Brother Kibria, Brother Fahim, Brother Imran, all the mistakes I did catch, even though there was something very minor, just mark it with the red pen, okay? In that way, this wouldn't happen again. And we joined this lesson to fix the fix our Quran as much as we can. So just mark it with the red pen or red pencil, pen, not pen, red pencil. So once we fix the mistake, we can rub it off, okay?
Inshallah.
Okay, Bismillah, brother Amin.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب
عليهم. Okay, can you say it from here again? I don't know. Okay, say it from اهدنا
اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين.
آمين ما شاء الله. Okay, اهدنا الصراط المستقيم. You need to make this a bit more full mouth, so it becomes a sword. This sword, sorry, let me just mark in blue because you're already correct. This sword, you're already correct. You said surah, very very good sword, but in this sword, it was more in between sword and sin. So we need to fix this sword. Ihdina sirat al-mustaqim. And then, is that okay? Ihdina sirat al-mustaqim.
But when you said this, sirat al-mustaqim.
Ihdina sirat al. Remember, there's two full mouth. One is sword and one is ta. Mustaqim, yeah. And then when you came to the next verse, sirat al-ladina, this sword was very good. Al-ladina, you said al-lazina, okay? It has to be, it's a dhal, it's a softer one. It's not a za. It's not the letter after ra. It's not the ra za. It's dal dal. The letter after dal, yeah? Alladhina, alladhina, not allazina. And beside that, the rest of the Quran, the rest of the surah was good. So just mark this sword and this zal, yeah?
Okay.
And then let's go to Surah Nas.
A'udhu billahi minash shaytanir rajim. Bismillahir rahmanir rahim. قل أعوذ برب الناس ملك الناس إله الناس من شر الوسواس الخناس الذي يوسوس في صدور الناس من الجنة والناس.
Okay, mashallah, good reading. Same problem here. الذي, it's not الذي, it's not a za, it's a dal, it's a dal, yeah, it's a letter after dal, dal dal, not ra and za. Not za. Yeah. So you have to make this a bit more softer. Alladhi, dhal. Alladhi, dha, dha, dha. Look at my face. Now look at me.
Yeah.
Tip of the tongue and the bottom of the teeth. Dha, 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 dha.
Alladhi.
Alladhi. Yeah. If you touch both of your front teeth together, it becomes a za. Zzz. No. Dha, dha. Yeah. Okay. Good.
Yeah.
And then this one, sharri. It's empty mouth. I told everyone, the ra has a shadda, so we look at what's on the shadda. If there's a kasra, empty. If there's a fatha or dhamma, it's full mouth. Yeah? Min sharril waswasil khannas. Anyway, yeah, it's a good reading. Mashallah, very good reading. Okay? What we'll do, some tajweed rules, and then at the end, we'll do the surah Qul huwa Allahu ahad and Qul a'udhu bi rabbil falaq, inshallah. Before that, everyone started surah Fatiha with A'udhu Billahi Minash Shaitan Rajeem. That's very good, because we start in Qira'ah, we started recitation. When we start reciting Quran, we have to start with Ta'awud, A'udhu Billahi Minash Shaitan Rajeem, Allah protect us from Shaitan. And then we ask Allah's help with Bismillahir Rahman Rahim. But when we start another surah, we don't really have to say A'udhu Billahi Minash Shaitan Rajeem. It's not sin, but we don't keep saying A'udhu Billah. So imagine I start Surah Nas, I don't say A'udhu Billah. Start Surah Falak, I don't say. Just separate two surahs with Bismillah. Yeah? So I think, I don't know exactly, but I think one or two brothers, when they started Surah Nas, they started A'udhu Billah again. You don't have to read A'udhu Billah. Unless you've done something which breaks your A'udhu Billah. Like you started talking, you went to drink water, you started doing anything else unrelated to Quran. Okay, when I was speaking to you and I was catching your mistakes in Surah Fatiha, it was something related to Quran. So our A'udhu Billah doesn't break. Okay, but don't get me wrong. It's not a sin to read A'udhu Billah again. It just doesn't sound nice to keep A'udhu Billah. That's why in the module one, I taught the rules of A'udhu Billah and Bismillah. When we start reading Quran, First, we say A'udhu Billah, and then Bismillah. And then every time we start a new surah, we just say Bismillah. And if imagine we have to stop for something related to Quran, I had to ask this brother, brother, can you help me with this verse? He helped me with this verse. When I come back, when I resume to my reading, I just say Bismillah. But if I ask someone to give me water, or I had to go and answer my door, and I come back, I have to say A'udhu Billah again because I've done something unrelated to Quran. Okay? It's just some masail of A'udhu Billah and Bismillah. If you go to our slides on first module, you can see all the rulings there. Okay, mashallah. MashaAllah, everyone. Bismillah. Okay. We've done izhar of nun sakin and tanwin. That's easy and nice and clear. We read it clear and fast. We've done iqlab. Iqlab means to change after nun sakin and tanwin. If the letter meme comes, we have to change the nun sakin into a meme sakin, or we have to change the tanwin into a meme sakin. That's very good. That's nice and clear. In the Quran, we will get a small, tiny little meme, which is going to indicate that this rule is happening. Yeah? Can you see there's a meme here? But it's still best to know the rule. Okay? Next one, we do idgham. Idgham is merging or ignoring. every time in the Quran, there's a sakin, and after the sakin, if there's a shadda, we always ignore the sakin. But we don't necessarily do gunnah. We only do gunnah when there's a nun sakin and then these few letters after nun sakin, yeah? Yawa mimnun. Idgham is divided into two categories. Category number one is idgham without sakin. Idgham without gunnah. The first category is idgham with gunnah. It's yawa mimnun, okay? Like this one. But we have to ignore this nun. And then we do gunnah. We don't say famay ya'mal. We say famay ya'mal. So we ignore the noon, but we done gunnah on the ya. Famay ya'mal. And the second category is idgham without gunnah. There's two letters. The first one is ra, and the other one is lam. The examples are there. Okay. So the example of, I'm just doing a quick recap on everything. Okay. So the example of with gunnah is here. I ignore this completely. Same here, I ignore the tanween on the fa. Instead of saying ka'as fin, we say ka'as fim ma'kul. And the one without kunna is here. Yakun lahu. You don't say yakun lahu. If you say yakun lahu, we are reading the noon. But idgham means we ignore it. Okay, so we ignore the noon and we also don't do kunna. We don't say yakun lahu. Lam and ra. These are the two letters we don't do gunnah. Next one we go to is ikhfa. Ikhfa is hard to practice and it's hard to get a grip of because I can't really show with my tongue and with my lips and mouth where exactly the gunnah is getting pronounced from, where the gunnah, the sound of gunnah is coming from. But what we have to know in this rule is that after nun sakin or tanwin, if one of these 15 letters come, we don't ignore the nun. Okay, we don't ignore the noon, but we don't read the noon as well. So we don't ignore it, but we don't read it. We do something in between. We hide the noon and we take the sound. We just read the, we take the sound in our notes. So instead of saying antum, instead of saying an, I say antum, antum. Instead of saying kutubun qayyima, we say kutubun qayyima. This would take a lot of practice, okay? Ikhfa takes a lot of practice because it's got the most letters plus the sound is a bit complicated to pinpoint. Anyway, so we know what izhar is. If I say, brother Fahim, what is izhar? Just tell me what izhar is. You don't have to tell me the letters. What is the ruling of izhar? What's the things we do in izhar? There's two things we do in izhar. What are they, brother Fahim?
Assalamu alaikum. Can you hear me?
Yeah. Yeah. There's two things we do in izhar. What are they?
Yeah.
What are the two things we do? We read it clear and fast. MashaAllah. So izhar, every time someone says izhar to you, if they ask you what is the ruling of nun sakin and tanwin izhar, then you say obviously after nun sakin and tanwin, if these six letters come, the letters of the throat, then we have to read it clear and fast. But izhar itself, it means clear. Okay? Clear and fast. What about iqlab, brother Imran? What does iqlab mean? What's the two things we do in iqlab?
You change and do
gunna. Okay, brother Kibria, what do we do in idgham? Don't worry about the one with gunna without gunna. Just idgham itself. What's the two things we do in idgham?
Is that the one? No, is it merge?
Merge and gunna. Merge and gunna. Mashallah. And the last one, brother Amin, what do we do in ikhfa? The two things we do in ikhfa.
Ikhfa. It's the 16 letters, right? So
yeah. What the two things we do?
We I don't know if it's the right term to use, that you join it to the next letter, as in okay, hide and gunna.
We hide the letter. We don't say antum. We say antum. The one we join is idgham. Idgham, we ignore that letter and we join it to the next letter, or we merge it to the next letter. Okay. In other words, idgham, you can say we join it. Okay. Merge or join. Because what do we do? Instead of reading the noon, instead of reading this noon, we join it with this ya, or we ignore this noon, or we merge it to the ya. So that's more like joining and merging. Yeah. Ikhfa is, we don't join it at all. We just read the, we just hide the nun sakin and we do gunna. Okay?
Okay.
Mim sakin is very easy as long as you understood nun sakin. Mim sakin has got three rules. Okay? But mim sakin, nun sakin rules were nun sakin and tanwin. Okay. Why is nun sakin and tanwin rule similar? Why is it that every time nun sakin has something, tanwin has to come with it? I've explained it.
It is the same sound.
The same sound, mashallah. They look different, but they make the same sound. But mim sakin and tanwin, they don't. Because mim sakin is am, but tanwin is an. So that's why mim sakin, it has its own ruling. Yeah? So let's do the rules of mim sakin. Let's start with mim sakin. Let's start with the last one. No. Okay, let's start with this one. Mim sakin only has three rules. Rule number one only has one letter. Rule number two only has one letter. And rule number three has all the letters, the remaining letters. So there's 28 letters in Arabic alphabet. Rule number one has one. Rule number two has one. And the remaining 26. Remaining 26 are on the other rule. So it's very easy. Okay. The first rule is ikhfa mim sakin. What is ikhfa mim sakin? After mim sakin, if the letter ba comes, don't get it mixed up with idgham. Don't get mixed up with nun sakin. Nun sakin, if after nun sakin ba comes, what rule is it? It's ikhlab. Yeah? It's ikhlab. But in mim sakin, if ba comes, it's ikhfa. Okay? After mim sakin, if the letter ba comes, you'll do ikhfa. How would you do ikhfa? I'll show you. This is called ikhfa shafawi. Because of mim sakin. It's not ikhfa nun sakin, it's ikhfa mim sakin. You can say ikhfa shafawi or you can say ikhfa mim sakin. And there's one other thing, brothers, don't worry too much. They don't come in the Quran a lot. Okay? Nun sakin and tanween is full in the Quran. So, ikhfa nun sakin, ikhfa nun sakin, ikhlab nun sakin, idgham nun sakin, izhar nun sakin, they are full of Quran. Yeah? These mim sakin rules, they are very little. Okay, so you wouldn't really come across a lot. Okay, look at this example. Yuhasibukum. We don't say yuhasibukum. What do we do in ikhfa? We hide. So how would you say this? Just say in your own. You can unmute yourself and say, or just say while you're muted. Just see. What we have to do here is after mim sakin, the letter ba came. Now I have to ignore, I have to hide the mim sakin. Okay? I can't say yuhasibukum. I say yuhasibukum bihillah. I don't say yuhasibukum. I don't join my lips. I say yuhasibukum bihillah. Can you see there's a gap? My lip doesn't move when I say him. Yuhasibukum. So the way we said antum, we took the sound to our nose, we take the same sound to our nose. Okay? Is that clear? Yuhasibukum bihillah.
Yeah, it's clear.
Okay, it's clear. These are going to come. These mim sakin and nun sakin, I keep telling you over and over again, these mim sakin and nun sakin rules, they'll come slowly. It just needs practice. So what you do from today, inshallah, 1 week, concentrate on, izhar is very nice and clear. Yeah? Izhar is very nice and clear because we read it fast and clear. Iqlab is very easy because it's only got one letter. The only two rules we have to concentrate on is idgham and ikhfa. Take idgham for 1 week. Every time you come across an idgham letter or every time you read Quran, just try to pinpoint all the idgham. Okay? 1 week, you'll master it. Or take 2 weeks. There's no rush. And then the next 2 weeks, concentrate on ikhfa. Afternoon sakin tanwin thakim. Afternoon sakin tanwin rakim. Ra is idgham. Zakim. Afternoon sakin tanwin qaf came. I have to do ikhfa. You will master it, inshallah. So is this ikhfa clear for everyone?
Yep.
Yeah. Okay. Brother Kibria?
Yeah, so it's pretty similar to the previous. It's
similar to the other ikhfa, but this is ikhfa with mim sakin. With the mim, with okay. Yes. Okay. The other rule as well, idgham mim sakin is same. It's similar to the other idgham. We merge because the next letter is a shadda. Okay. But this is coming after a mim sakin, not after a nun sakin. Okay. Let's look at this rule. Idgham of mim sakin. Why is idgham of mim sakin? The rule is after mim sakin, if the letter mim comes. So mim sakin and after mim sakin, the exact same letter mim came with a shadda. It's going to come. It is going to be a shadda. That's what idgham is. Then you will merge the two memes together and you'll just read the second meme. But once, okay, and this is called ikhfa shafawi. The only reason they call it shafawi is because it's meme. You don't really need to call it ikhfa shafawi. You can call it ikhfa mim sakin. You can call it idgham mim sakin. Yeah, look at this. وآمنهم من خوف فليعبدوا رب هذا البيت الذي أطعمهم من جوع وآمنهم من خوف. It seems like, wait, let me just cross this off, then I can zoom inside. So, it seems like, when I read this, it seems like I'm reading this meme, but in reality, I'm crossing this off, I'm ignoring it. This ha is catching this meme. وَآمَنَهُمْ مِنْ خَوْفِ. Same with the other example. عَلَيْهِمْ مُؤْصَدَ. Okay, because the first meme is getting ignored. Like the rest of the idgham in nun sakin or the any other letter when sakin and shadda joins, we always ignore the sakin because the sakin is weaker. Okay, so that should be straightforward. Any other letter beside ba? Sorry,
sir. I was going to ask. Do you know? With this rule, I remember last time you mentioned one of the I don't know which module it was, but you mentioned, is it khayshum? And you mentioned nun shadda and mim shadda. So this is the same thing.
Nun shadda and mim shadda is wajib gunnah.
Okay.
Yeah, khayshum is the gunnah. Khayshum is the makhraj for gunnah. Okay. Khayshum is the sound from the nose. Okay. But every time, yeah. So mim ikhfa'im shafawi. Idgham shafawi is like it is going to be mim shadda. Okay. Wa amma. But remember one thing, every time mim shadda, it's not going to be idgham. Okay, because sometimes you get fa'amma al-yateema. That's amma. The mim has a shadda, but it's not idgham. Yeah, because the letter before is hamza. But every time, okay, I'll show you in the Quran. When I go to the Quran, I'll show you. But every time this comes, every time this rule comes, mim and mim, after mim sakin, there's another mim. Majority of the time that meme is going to be shadda. Okay, majority of the time it's going to be shadda. Here and there you might get one with the sakin. I can't really remember the examples, but majority of the time the second meme is going to have a shadda. Yeah, so you are going to do, in other words, you are going to do meme shadda gunna. Okay, but in here you're just doing it because of ikhfa meme shakin. Because look at this. Sometimes amma. Okay, فأما اليتيم فلا تقهرها وأما السائل فلا تنهر وأما بنعمة ربك فحدث. All those, or do you know أما يتساءلون عما يتساءلون. Let me just write my mind properly. أما. So all these are the example of ميم شدة and نون شدة. These are example of ميم and نون شدة. Okay, can you see? But before that ميم شدة, there is a, it's not a ميم, it's a حمزة and عين. So that's the rule of mim shadda and nun shadda. If they have, if mim has a shadda or nun has a shadda, we do gunna. But this is different. This is, the mim has to have another mim in front of it.
Okay.
Okay?
Yeah, I've got that. Okay. Exactly.
Okay, I mean, and the last one is simple. This last one is any other letter beside the meme, because the meme is taken by idgham, and beside the ba, because the ba is taken by which rule?
Ikhfa.
Ikhfa. Ba is taken by ikhfa. Let's go to ikhfa. Can you see the ba is taken here? So any other letter beside meme and ba is going to become the last category. What is the last category? It's izhar. We read it clear and fast. Okay. After meme, sakin, tanwin, if any other letter comes beside meme and ba, you have to do izhar and you have to read it clear and fast. Look at this. This is a example from the Quran. In أَرَأَيْتَ الَّذِي وَيَمْنَعُونَ الْمَاعُونَ وَيَمْنَعُونَ الْمَاعُونَ. The meme has a sakin. After meme sakin, which letter came? After meme sakin, noon came. Noon is not from, it's not ba or meme. So we have to read it clear and fast. We don't say وَيَمْنَعُونَ الْ. We say وَيَمْنَعُونَ الْمَاعُونَ. Fast and clear. Let's look at the other example. The next example is لَمْ يَلِدْ. وَلَمْ يُولَدْ. لَمْ يَلِدْ وَلَمْ يُولَدْ. Both of them are similar. After mim sakin, the letter ya came. Ya is not from, it's not ba. As long as it's not ba and mim, we have to read it clear and fast. If after mim sakin, if this was a nun sakin, say for instance, this was a nun sakin, and then ya came, what rule would have happened here?
The rule of Yarmalun. So
what is the rule of Yarmalun?
It's idgham.
Idgham. Yeah, we do gunnah, mashallah, but we ignore the nun sakin and we do gunnah. We don't say lam, we don't say lan yalid, we say lain yalid. There will be a shadda here. We say lain yalid. Okay, so is that clear for everyone? The rules, don't worry about idgham mim sakin. It doesn't come in the Quran as much, but it's best to know it because it is a part of the rulings of the Quran. Yeah. And then after that, what do we have left? We don't have anything left. We go to module 4, inshallah. Is it clear or any more explanation needed?
I think more practice.
Practice, more practice needed. Easily, inshallah, more practice needed. Let me go to Quran. I'll explain it to everyone from the Quran, inshallah. And then at the end, we will do our surahs. Okay. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم If you can point any out, you're more than welcome to point it out. If you see a mim sakin, after mim sakin, any letter, it can be mim sakin, after mim sakin, mim. After mim sakin, it can be a mim. After mim sakin, it can be a ba. Or after mim sakin, it can be any other letter. Just let me know.
Famallam. Mim sakin at the bottom.
Yeah. Famallam.
The second ayah.
Yes.
So,
Famallam yajid. MashaAllah. Famallam yajid. Okay, wait. What I will do, I will zoom out, then we can get more examples done.
Okay. Ustad, the second ayah.
Yes.
So, where it says, Alladhina yutahhiruna minkum min nisa. So there you've got meme, and then you've got meme with a shadda.
Mm-hmm.
So you got meme sakin, and it's followed by another meme.
Yeah. So
the
rule
is
idgham. Yeah. Yes, mashallah, this one. There's another one here. There's an exact same one here. Yaquluna inna Allah. Ihim. There's another one here, mim sakin, but there's a tha after it. So after mim sakin, if tha comes, what do we do? What do we do?
It's izhar.
Min nisa'ihim thumma. The only two letters we have to worry about is mim and noon. Mim and ba. Mim is idgham and ba is ikhfa. Yeah? Faman lam yastati' fa it'amu 60 min qabli. You don't get much. Look. I can't see any more in this page. So you only get few. But if I try to point out all the nun sakin ones, now let's find all the nun sakin ones. There's a nun sakin one here. There's a nun sakin one here. Min nisaim, there's a nun sakin one here. In ummahun ummatim. In ummatum, there's a nun sakin idgham here. إلا إولدناهم وإنهم لا يقولون منكرا. There's a noon second here. إن الله لعفون. There's a noon second here. الذين يظهرون من نساء. There's a noon second here. Can you see how many noon second rules you get? There's a noon second yeah. here. There's a tanwin here. But compared to noon second, mim second, you don't get much. So in that way, it's okay, but we still need to practice. Is that okay with everyone? The rules, the examples are not. Okay. Let's, any questions? If there's no questions, we will go to the next surah, inshallah. Okay. Okay. A'udhu billahi minash shaytan. All the mistakes I caught from all the brothers, just mark it and practice on those mistakes. Okay. Inshallah, by end of module 4, we should know our last 4 surahs without any major or without any minor mistakes. Okay. Okay. Do you know, alhamdulillah, we finished module 3. All the tajweed rules are more or less done. There's no more rules to learn. There are few minor rules left. I'll cover those in module 4. Module 4 will be more like informations. Okay. How to stop. How to stop on ramta. How to stop on fatha, dhamma, kasra. How to stop on stretching. There are some letters. They don't join with the next letter. We call it naughty letters. Okay. We'll cover it in module 4. And there's other things like sajda, how many sajdas in the Quran, what's the symbols of stopping symbols, why is there so many stopping symbols? Like, I wouldn't go in details, otherwise it's going to take me long. I will just say which ones we stop in and which ones we don't really need to stop, we just carry on. There's one we have to stop, there's one we cannot stop, and the rest of them is up to you. Okay, inshallah I'll explain it. If I try to explain what is ta, you know, the ta you have here, the jim you have here, if I try to explain all these, it's going to take a long time, okay? So what I will do, I will just say the necessary stop, there's one letter. Necessary continuation, one letter. The rest of the letters is up to you, okay? And then ayah, the circle, how to stop on the circle, what is ruku? Inshallah, there's a lot of information, but there's nothing to practically learn. So whatever was practically learning is done. Like, Ikhfa is hard, full mouth, stretching, how to stop, makhraj. All these are practically, you have to practically revise. These are all gone. Module 4 is more like information module, yeah? Okay, inshallah, we'll do that from next week or the week after, okay? Okay, a'udhu billahi minash shaitanir rajim. Can everyone go to Surah Falaq? Qul a'udhu birabbil falaq. A'udhu billahi minash shaitanir rajim.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم
Okay, let me just zoom into that line. Okay. قل أعوذ برب الفلق
قل
أعوذ برب الفلق
قل أعوذ برب الفلق
من شر ما خلق
من شر ما خلق
Okay. Remember the qaf, I've marked it blue because it's a full mouth letter. قل أعوذ Alif has to be strong, Ayn has to be a bit softer. أعوذ برب الناس Ra is full mouth. That's why I marked it blue. Ra is full mouth because it's got a fatha. Why did I mark فلق? The qaf is full mouth. That's good. But there's another
Khalqala.
Yeah. This surah, all the last letters of this surah is Khalqala. Okay, so inshallah, end of this lesson and end of this surah, your Khalqala should be, and then same with the next surah, Surah Ikhlas, we're going to do Qul huwa Allahu Ahad, all the last letters, they're Khalqala. So by the time we finish revising these two, our Khalqala should be mastered, inshallah. Min sharri, why did I mark it blue?
Letter of Ikhfa.
Ikhfa, min sharri. We don't say min sharri. We say min sharri. What about the ra? What happens in that ra? Is it full mouth or empty mouth?
Empty.
Empty
mouth. Same. Do you know min sharri al-waswasil khannas? Min sharri al-waswasil khannas. Same sharri. So, mashallah, empty mouth. Ma khalaq. Why did I put two reds there?
Full mouth,
and then obviously khalqala. Full mouth, and khalqala. Mashallah, good. Let me just read these two verses again, then we'll go to the next page. Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. قُلْ أَعُوذُ بِرَبِّ الْفَلَقَ
قُلْ أَعُوذُ بِرَبِّ الْفَلَقَ
مِنْ شَرِّ مَا خَلَقَ
مِنْ شَرِّ مَا خَلَقَ
MashaAllah. Is that good with everyone?
Yeah.
Okay, let's go to the next page. وَمِنْ شَرِّ Yes. I'll just write a wow here. Wow, okay. وَمِن شَرِّ غَاسِقٍ
وَمِن شَرِّ غَاسِقٍ
Okay. Yeah, sorry. I just stopped in ghasiqin. I was not meant to stop there. وَمِن شَرِّ غَاسِقٍ إِذَا وَقَبَ
وَمِن شَرِّ غَاسِقٍ إِذَا وَقَبَ
Yeah. So وَمِن شَرِّ we are going to do إخفاء here again, like before. All the min شَرِّ, all the starting of the verse. Look at the remaining here. All of them they have إخفاء. Yeah. وَمِنْ شَرِّ وَمِنْ شَرِّ So your ikhfa is going to become mastered, inshallah. وَمِنْ شَرِّ That's ikhfa. شَرِّ I marked the ra again because it's going to be empty mouth because it's got a kasra. غَاسِقٍ Remember, غَا is full mouth. I didn't mark the غَين but let me mark it. Okay? غَين is full mouth. سِقِن قَاف Even though it's got two kasra, am I going to make it full mouth or empty mouth?
Full mouth.
Sometimes people think there's a kasra underneath so I'm going to make it empty mouth. غَاسِقِن No, not غَاسِقِن غَاسِقِن If you try to make empty mouth, it becomes another letter. It becomes the small calf. Ida. Why did I mark it yellow?
One alif long.
That's good. But there's another thing is people say Iza instead of Ida. My tongue, tip of the tongue is touching the tip of my the bottom of my front two teeth. Tha, not Iza. You don't join the front two teeth. If I join these, Z, it makes a stronger sound. I have to say idha waqab. Qaf is full mouth. That's why I marked it red and ba is qalqala. Yeah. Wa min sharri ghasiqin idha waqab. MashaAllah. Wa min sharri ikhfa again here. وَمِن شَرِّ النَّفَّاثَاتِ فِي الْعُقَدِ
وَمِن شَرِّ النَّفَّاثَاتِ فِي الْعُقَدِ
Okay, I'm going to explain this verse later. Let's finish the next one. وَمِن شَرِّ حَاسِدٍ إِذَا حَسَدَ
وَمِن شَرِّ حَاسِدٍ إِذَا حَسَدَ
Remember all the ra with the shadda and they have a kasra, we have to make it empty mouth. And all the noon, afternoon, afternoon second is a sheen, afternoon second is a sheen, afternoon second is a sheen. We have to do ikhfa. Okay, why did I mark the dal? Because there's izhar. It's nothing to worry about, but there's izhar. This dal I marked it because after tanwin, hamza came izhar. Okay, let's go to the first verse, this verse. Wa min sharri is ikhfa, ra is empty mouth. Noon, why did I mark this noon? Noon shadda, mim shadda, we have to do gunna. If noon has a shadda, mim has a shadda, we have to do gunna. Why did I mark this tha? Let me see.
Some people say sa. I don't
know. Oh, that's it. It's not because of there's a long stretching. No, because the letter before the fa has a long stretching. I didn't mark the fa. Okay, can you see the fa has a long stretching as well? The tha. Mm-hmm. I didn't mark it because of the long stretching. Instead of people saying tha, they say sa. So the way they say thal, instead of thal, they say za. Instead of tha, 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 tha is soft. Tha. They say they say sa. They make the tha into a sin. Yeah? So we should try to avoid that. Wa min sharri nafathati fil 'uqad. Okay, qaf is a full mafrata. Wa min sharri hasidin idha hasad. I'm going to read this surah one more time and then inshallah we'll go to the next surah. A'udhu billahi minash shaitanir rajim. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم
قل أعوذ برب الفلق
قل أعوذ برب الفلق
من شر ما خلق Remember this surah, all the verses gonna start with min sharri, min sharri, min sharri. Remember ikhfa, yeah? And all the verses gonna finish with the qaf. Qaf or dal, any letters from the qalqala, qaf, dal or ba, yeah? Waqab, hasad, like that. So the last letter is qalqala and the first word is ikhfa in this surah, yeah? Okay, let's go to the next one. I have to keep changing the page. Okay. وَمِن شَرِّ غَاسِقٍ إِذَا وَقَبْ
وَمِن شَرِّ غَاسِقٍ إِذَا وَقَبْ
وَمِن شَرِّ النَّفَّاثَاتِ فَثَاتِ فِي الْعُقَدِ
وَمِنْ شَرِّ النَّفَّاثَاتِ فِي الْعُقَدِ
وَمِنْ شَرِّ حَاسِدٍ إِذَا حَسَدَ
وَمِنْ شَرِّ حَاسِدٍ إِذَا حَسَدَ.
Okay, someone said إِذَا. Sorry, it's not. Let me just get the highlighter. Ida, Ida, Tha, and Ida. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Okay. Is this okay with everyone? Remember these Tha and that and Tha. They are a bit softer. If I change this Thal, it'll become a Za. If I change this Tha, it'll become a Sin. And then what happens? What would happen? Is it something very big? Is it something major? Major mistake. You can change the meaning. If it doesn't change the meaning, you're changing how Allah revealed the Quran. Yeah. Okay. Mm-hmm. Let's go to our Surah Ikhlas, and then inshallah we will finish, unless there's any question. Bismillahirrahmanirrahim.
Bismillahirrahmanirrahim.
قل هو الله أحد
قل هو الله أحد
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 أحد is because that all the last letters in this surah again is going to have قلقلة because it's one of the قلقلة letters and you make it into a ساكن. قل هو الله أحد
قل هو الله أحد
الله الصمد
الله الصمد
الله الصمد
الله الصمد.
Remember this is a sad, yeah, not a sin. لم يلد ولم يولد
لم يلد ولم يولد
the letter has a قلقلة, all of them, yeah. وَلَمْ يَكُنْ لَهُ كُفُوًا أَحَدٌ وَلَمْ يَكُنْ لَهُ كُفُوًا أَحَدٌ
وَلَمْ يَكُنْ لَهُ كُفُوًا أَحَدٌ
Okay, let me just say the first one. Why did I mark... let me just get a different color so we understand it. Why did I mark the qaf red? Because it's a full maf.
Yeah.
Okay, full maf. Allah, why did I mark it red?
Full maf.
Full maf Allah, why?
Because it has a zobo
before it. Yeah, mashallah. Yeah, okay. Dal, why did I mark it? But I thought the letters of Qalqala, they need to have a sakin. There is no sakin here, there's two dhamma.
No, it's at the end.
Because you're stopping.
I'm stopping, I'm putting a temporary sakin.
Yeah.
Originally, it's got two dhamma. But because I'm stopping, I'm putting a temporary sakin. Like, look at this sakin. This sakin is permanent. Do you know the sakin here? This is a permanent sakin. This is a permanent sakin. But this ahadun, it was meant to be ahadun. But because I'm stopping, I'm putting a temporary sakin. MashaAllah. This Allah, why did I mark it?
Full mouth.
Okay,
this sword, what did I mark it?
Full mouth.
Dala marked it because it's Qalqala. Okay, lam. Okay, we'll come back to the yellow later. Yalid Qalqala again, yeah? Yulad Qalqala again. Walam yakullahu. Okay, why did I mark this lam yellow?
It's an ikhfa.
It's an ikhfa of Mim Sakin. No, it's not Ikhfa of Mim Sakin. It's not Ikhfa of Mim Sakin. It's Izhar of Mim Sakin. We've done it today. Anything beside Ba and Mim, I put this example there as well. Lam Yalid. Yeah? Walam Yulad. So these are just what we've done today. After Mim Sakin, the letter Ya came. And the letter Ya is not Ba and Mim. So we have to do Izhar. If it was Ba and Mim, then it would have been Idgham or Ikhfa. Yeah? Same here. Walam yakun lahu same. So there's three examples from today's lesson. 1, 2, and 3. Walam yakun lahu. Okay, let's just delete all of them. What's here? What happens here?
Yeah.
I got this example as well.
Merge and ignore.
Merge and ignore. And?
No, you can't do gunnah.
You don't do gunnah. So merge and ignore only. No gunnah. MashaAllah. Merge and ignore. I get rid of this noon, and then half catches the lam. Instead of me saying walam yakun lahu, I say kul lahu. Yeah, that's idgham with gunna or without gunna.
Without
gunna. Kufuwan ahad. Kufuwan. The only reason I marked kufuwan was because it's hard of tanwin, and ahad is qalqala. I'm going to read this surah again. Is that clear and nice? Yeah.
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 Okay. Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم
قل هو الله أحد
قل هو الله أحد
الله الصمد
الله الصمد
لم يلد ولم يولد
لم يلد ولم يولد
ولم يولد قلقلة
ولم يولد
ولم يكن له كفوا أحد
ولم يكن له كفوا أحد
no, if you say أحد then it becomes like a شدة it's أحد bounce أحد not أحد
أحد
don't make it like it's
أحد
Yeah, don't make it like it's gonna stick and then it's gonna pull it out. Ahad, it's like that. It's meant to be ahad, just like a bouncing ball. Ahad, yeah, nice and soft. It just touches it and comes out. Okay, mashallah. There is a lot of people. They make a mistake here, but no one done it today, so I don't have to say. Some people say kul fu Allahu. I think that's the old generation, okay? I was trying to listen to if anyone says that, but mashallah, no one said it. That's why I didn't really put a mark in here. A lot of people say, Kul fu Allahu, but it's not. Anyway, mashallah, everyone, get these two surahs ready. at the same time, I'm still going to listen to your Surah Fatiha and Surah Nas. So I can just say, Brother Kibri, I can say Surah Fatiha, even though we're meant to do Surah Ikhlas and Surah Falaq. Qul huwa Allah and Qul a'udhu bil Falaq, but I can test on any Surah because we've done the other Surahs. Yeah? We've finished module 3. We've got module 4 left. Should we give next week a break? And then because the school break, other people might have other things to do. And then we'll start from, in that way, I can finalize my slides. And inshallah, we'll have a break as well. And inshallah, we'll start from as soon as the break finishes. Is that okay?
Yeah. I was going to say if we got a break or something, because I'm going to be going on leave. That's why. So.
Okay. Yeah. I think I need some break as well. Okay. what you do, but please, we're going to have a nice break, inshallah. But I want everyone to practice. Okay. In these 2 weeks, you've got till we have our next Wednesday lesson, we've got 14 days. In these 14 days, 7 days we master Idgham, 7 days we master Ikhfa. Is that okay?
Yeah.
Inshallah. Okay then. Yeah.
Wa alaikum salam.
Jazakallah khair. Assalamu alaikum.